What up, guys? Chilling out. Just mess with some cars. Yeah, just chilling out. And, pretty good at what I'm doing, but, here's your real how-to on how to make, your arms to deal with, got your little solenoid right there. Got your D2 springs and you got your eyelets. You can get the eyelets at Michael's or Hobby Lobby or sometimes Walmart got some. I get mine at Michael's because I can find them faster and stuff. But I got this. I got a little pin right here. Goes through. You got your ball joint. You got that. Then you got this. Then you glue this on top, from the top frame, then you glue this from the bottom. And if you don't want to do the ball joint style, that's like an upgrade to the real thing. You can put this on, take that piece off, and glue this piece right there. And you can drill another hole right there. You got this A-arm on there. It's like, just like this car has it. This one don't have the ball joints though. It just has a thing, the, piece of plastic. It has this. This, you gotta cut a U, drill your hole, glue on this please, and it works pretty good for what you want to do with that, but that's how your solenoids spring, get your plastic tubing, and you got your U arm set. There's just one thing I'd like to know. Just like that. Is your love still warm for me? Or has it grown cold? Your rims. This is a different. This has, if you should awake. It has a telescopic on that one. I'm still working on that telescopic though. This one has the original ring, so it has that. Drill your holes right there. That works pretty good. Good night, my love. Whirling bar out. Pleasant dreams. Sleep tight. Got your A-arms. G2 spring just the same. This car does have a good bounce too. And bring you closer to me. This one has a good bounce too, but the string popped on it, I think. If you should see? But I'm not too sure if I'm about to hop that pretty soon. I'm still working on it. But I got that. And that's how you mostly do it. It's like that. Pretty simple. Get your tubing at Hobby Place, your local hobby place, and ask for styrene. Good night, my love. Pleasant dreams and sleep tight, my love. May tomorrow be sunny. But they replace that pretty soon. This goes on my Cadillac. My other four-door Cadillac. So far I had the car painted. Romagitino or something like that. Got that light coated. Light coated. No, really deep into it. Now I'm about to cover it. Have the insides right here painted. Then the snake will be painted and stuff. Then this right here be painted. Right here. This will be painted too. Whole car will be painted. The same color. Got these, and I'm doing a bad back of the cab, and if y'all have a 69 Impala, it can be a convertible, or it can be a project one, stuff like that. I would trade one of my hydraulic cars for it too. You got this, putting out, tape on it. I hate my phone. Camera sucks on it. I had to adjust this camera at least. It'll be painted pretty soon. And I'm still looking for a 70 Monte Carlo. 70 Monte Carlo frame. And floorboard, floor pan. And yeah, I have a 69 or a 71 to a 73 to a 74 Impala, Caprice and Impala. Let me know. I might get to trade this. This is a 1/16 scale with A arms and standards in the back and stuff like that. It's all of that. And it's painted, the engine runs. Action moves, it does move the fan, so. Hold up, let me try to. Oof. My project. I'm not lying, if I gotta trade this to get me a, Impala something, like a different year Impala. Different year Impala, I can do it. This car does need to be finished. This is a, whoops, my bad. It does have steering. And I promise this is a 1/16 scale. And it does have A-arms. 1/16 scale, 1/16 A arms, top and bottom. Shorten the top so the wheels will stay tucked a little bit more. Some of them said it will mess up and go like that. No, it does not. I just like the style of how the wheels bend, and I like them straight because I'm old school like that. Like a pattern out. It is a little bit messed up, but this is a bigger body, and I don't think I sent it fully. Had it painted with, it has a white pearl. That's what the white is. I got the Kool-Aid purple, and that's just something to do a symbol for right here, right in the middle.
Is the engine? It does move. So I'm still detailing the engine, the insides, and has bar joints, and this is there. See that moving, but with the finish, the steering and everything, and I get really detailed my steering too. What I'm about to do for the right here, I'm about to detail that out. I'm about to have a battery and everything, the rack and everything stuff. And but let me know what y'all think and comment on it below and stuff like that. And the wheels does tuck in. It just it's like. That's how high it goes right now. Pretty cool. Wait until you see the servos on it. But has a cross on it, pattern out right here. Really smooth, really smooth. Pattern out. This is pearl. All the white is pearl. Do the sidings. Door opens and shuts. And I gotta fix it a little bit better. I'm gonna have to deck out the interior. So the other door's patterned out. But I got this. This is a 1/16 scale. To let y'all know, the wiring is right there for the lighting. I gotta replace the lights, but trying to look for the wire for the engine to show y'all how it works. Let's see the wiring. Hold up, let me see. It turns. And there goes the rear. It has a and this is a 1/16. It has original rear, what comes with the 16 scale, and it gets a trailing bar and it moves. Car rolls and stuff like that. Gotta work on the standards. I gotta make some bolt amounts for it, but this is a 1/16 scale, and this motor used to have been in a 1/24 scale, 25 scale. And, we try to show you at the same time why. Using this, you can use a smaller battery for this. Here's the wires, I'm still working on it, but pretty legit, it's pretty crazy. It's crazy how it does that. I gotta make a custom belt, homemade from scratch, because the original belt broke on me. There's like a fan. We can go backwards. It's pretty cool that the engine is detailed. It has a, the bottom is painted red. Top is done with silver, and this is chrome. This is done by silver. This is done by silver. Mostly all this detailed stuff, what you see down here, like the trimming and stuff like that, is done by the chrome. And I still gotta do this side right here, going all the way down here. These little letters right here. But this is legit. It works. It does mostly everything what I'm mostly been working on and stuff. And this thing has even G2 springs on it. G2 springs. I'm not lying to you. I was really shocking when I found out it can hold a G2 spring. Mostly crazy shocked about how small the trailing arms is, and I'll be really honest, I don't know when to just let y'all know. I don't know when. But this is a legit car. Let me try to flip it over. Here's a I'm gonna focus phone. Here's your rear end. You got your wishbone right there, and I basically glue that right there to that. This is a 1/16 scale, so it's gonna have a different kind of center in it. You might have a little bit thicker one. There we go, side of three wheel, both sides. The light shade of this one, because it's going to be there's going to be a mural on this and stuff like that. And this is going to be all chromed, and the wire runs out of the engine and goes like that. The transmission is going to be really detailed. It's going to be mostly fanned, and I'm going to try to see if I can fit in there. But here's your 1/16 scale A-arms, and you see the lights. You saw the light on here until it took a crud. But here's your A-arms. Pretty legit what you can do with the 1/16 scale. You can do a lot of details. I can even win the hopping competition with this. I am getting custom wheels. I'm about to buy custom wheels for it. And you can tell I'm not that best at using a paintbrush for that, because this is really small. But you see those other builds that I'm doing at this moment. And I'll be working on the steering pretty soon for this car, the 55 Nomad. And I got that big old scale. We're just waiting until I do something with it. But somebody cash me up, or cash me out, or if them find a, if they got a 69 Impala. Or a 69 Impala, or a 71, or a 72, or 73 Impala, or Caprice, let me know. I would like to trade stuff. And I got another Nomad I'm working with. Got this Nomad. No engine on it, but it does have the A-arms. I gotta glue that. But it has the A-arms. Mostly it has a rear end. Custom made rear end. I got it from my Cadillac. That one, which I can customize again. Another one. I'm not in a little depot hurry. The heck? Well, this might help y'all. You run a pin through him. Oops, I'm trying to run it. Both ends. But, there you go. And these grills right here will make a good cutlass grill. A LS grill, pretty good grill, but no AMs for, no hydraulics, well, no servos in it yet. It's just a display car for a while there. Now it's mirrored out and decked out, but it's a charcoal color, dark charcoal, pretty nice color. It's pretty clean. Got another 64 I'll be doing pretty soon. Oops. I got that one. 64. And got this one. My People's Choice Reward 63. Got the Regal. Got the Cadillac. That Cadillac's pretty old. That came out of the original green Cadillac kit. Not the pink one, not the purple one. I got even proof on that one. Oh, there it is. There's that it. But, I got that cutlass. But let me know about this one if anybody wants it. I got that one. I got the two up there, which I can sell. Let me know what's up. Got this right here. So this hopper, this does get off the ground, I'm not gonna lie. If you buy a Johnson, this car will get off the ground too. I got a Johnson in that one, 130 motor. And it will work pretty good. I'm about to put a Johnson in this one too. But I'm about to just do the patterns at this moment and kind of chill out stuff. Got the top painted. I'm about to have to cover some areas so I can do more colors. But I got this wide body right here. This is a wide body 69 I'm creating. It was a 70 Impala until I cut the front end, remodifying it stuff. If you got 69 parts, let me know. Bumper and front pieces, anything, let me know. Grill and stuff, let me know. Her hood, that hood does not fit it no more. Might have to do a custom hood if nobody don't have one. There's my Cadillac. I got that 63 wagon. Got that little truck if anybody wants it. Got the ice cream truck I'm working on. Got those 16 skull, and I got that one, the 55. Got an old truck I had from my first car show I went to. I got second place for it, not bad for the very first time. I got my trailer. I got an old school Penn's oil diecast. That's the only diecast I sort of have. I got the old police car. But let me know. Still rocking, and peace.